First session back. Didn't want to do any lifting. We arrived back at 5 a.m. at home this morning. Slept all day.
I think this bike counts wrong because I beat my 10 minutes max cows. I got 183. And then I just averaged like just under 17 cows a minute for 30 minutes. Unless the rest did me good or all this cardio is paying off. What I did, first 10 minutes, 60 to 65 for 30 seconds, 80 for 30 seconds. On, off, on, off, on, off, 10 minutes. So the next 20 minutes, I did 55 to 60 RPM for 30 seconds, 80 to 83 RPM for 30 seconds. So it was a push. Really sweating, really good. I got a good workout, that's the main thing. £30 ball ball versus Jazz.
Yeah.
Is it your song?
It's my song. First ever muscle up. Right there.
Abigail, first muscle up ever bar.
Is it your only one?
Huh?
Is it your only one?
No, I've got a couple more.
CrossFit.
Not CrossFit. Jazz, have you been on holiday?
I have.
I was a little bit sweaty. She wanna try when I leave that house. Gucci the flatters, oh yeah. Kool-Aid jammer, cookie back on camera. No, she wanna twerk on my chain, getting it. Diamonds ain't drip like a lake. Ali a team, kids love it.
What we go out, that's how it's supposed to be. Living young and wild and free.
Rate my performance.
8.
You're like one of those supportive families on The X Factor that tells them that they can actually do it, but really they're traveling. Traveling sometimes is a killer.
Yo, how many days now, Jazz?
Good.
That hustle.
That's it, mate. Hands down. 15 seconds, brother. Keep moving.
What is going on, Team Craig? We're back with another commentary over today's video, and this honestly is probably the first legit day of training that we had all week. If you'd watched the previous vlog, we spent the week before in Cyprus 7 days. Now that 7 days, we literally did one day of training. So getting back into it after a 5.5 hour flight home, landing at like 3 a.m. in the morning, getting home at 4 a.m. It took me just 2 days of cardio to kind of like refresh the body before it even felt ready to lift. Like I could have gone straight back into the programming, but I honestly didn't feel like that would have been optimal. But anyway, how the program's structured is Monday is usually a squat and pull gymnastics day with a lot of heavy conditioning. Tuesday is usually an hour long aerobic piece, and then Wednesday is deadlift, posterior chain, and then a more intense style Metcon. What you're seeing on the screen right now isn't actually part of the programming. It's an extra little bit. I've started a deadlift cycle just because my deadlift itself is pretty strong, but when you look at my deadlift endurance, my posterior chain endurance, it's really, compared to my squat, it's really not where it needs to be. And the impact that has on many other things like dumbbell snatch, high volume cleans, is fundamental that I get it up. So I actually sent Will Kane a message and I was like, dude, what can I do to increase my deadlift? And he sent me this weightlifting 101. Basically, you start off week one with half of your max deadlift and you do it for 20 touch and go reps. And then every week you just add on 2.5 to 5 kilos until you can't do that anymore. And then afterwards you do 3 back off sets of 10 reps and you just do that once a week. So I'm going to do it every Wednesday. Straight away after, we then went back onto the programming, straight leg Romanian deadlifts, managed 110 kilos as well for 4 sets of 8 reps. And honestly, like, felt really good. The next 4 or 5 days, you're going to see my hamstrings definitely just felt like they'd been battered, but that's what I need right now. As you're gonna see, we then went on to just do some gymnastics and core work. The EMOMs, honestly, the pull gymnastics, the core EMOMs, and the push gymnastic EMOMs, they look the easiest on paper, but they're actually the worst. But this one was pretty funny. Was really happy with how my toaster bar felt. And then we went on to do a 3-part Metcon, which you will see. And honestly, it was the first time I've ever done box step overs with dumbbells in my hands. Went out way too hot on the first part of 3. And really just died a complete death for the rest of the workout. Redlined way too early and just had a terrible time. The dumbbell box step overs, see, I don't know how they do it with 32.5s. They were unbelievably hard. So if you've never tried it in your actual programming, just chuck them in, maybe do 50 for time with just 22.5s and realize how much they, more than anything, attack your grip and your forearms, and you really have to just put up with that burn. So, but also I think because my body is not used to the high volume, yeah, the deadlifts and Romanians really put me in a bad place for the workout. Like it really impacted on the workout. But anyway, still did it, still got it done, and enjoyed it. If you have enjoyed this commentary, smash that like button. I hope you enjoy the rest of the video. I hope you get a bit of an insight into my training for the week. It was a solid week of training, and we'll talk to you guys later on in the video.
Come on, Craig.
I look concerned because it's...
Your legs look really long.
So these are in the program, and I've never done them before. And it's nice to mix it up every so often, but this straddle leg lift. Sit upright. I might actually be getting cramp.
Right, oh, ooh. You start to feel with your quads cramping.
Wow, that is a face and a half.
I feel like those divers. Yep.
My legs are like jelly.
My whole body is like jelly. Dairy milk or caramel? Dairy milk or caramel? This is a melted caramel. I'll say it the American way. Caramel. Caramel? Caramel. It's caramel. Caramel.
It's all about the cream eggs. It's all about the cream eggs.
Yeah, it is. Oh, yes, but there's none in here. So I literally, I went out too fast. Probably already said this in the commentary, but I went out too fast. And then the last two rounds, I honestly thought I wasn't going to finish. I was like, no. What did you say, Matt?
I started off slow and got slower.
I love him. What a guy.
Yeah. A year ago today, we hit 50k last time we were in Cyprus. Now we're on 112k.
And how many members have Faber got now?
We are on 158. We've had two more. That's just 156. Look what we get 160. Have you seen?
Skier.
Skier.
We're home. I have now lost all of my clothes. Jeff, what has he been doing for the couple of weeks that we've been away? You know, it's a hard life he's got. Really, you know, working.
He said to me just before.
Hey, listen, first time I sat down today.
Well, I've been doing housework all day long.
You've
but, you know,
a dog and he's been for lunch with his friends.
It's times like this when I can sit down and reflect just how lucky I am.
You've even got a cushion for your foot.
Good, isn't it?
Yeah.
Life's great, isn't it?
You been all right?
Yeah, I've been good. Really good, thank you. Yep. Thank you for your concerns.
Back on the machine. We're back at the track. Fridays at the track, is that's what it's going to be from now on. For the next 12 weeks, team training programming, running cycle, done the Rowan one. Yeah.
Hello, Steph.
Hiya.
Look cool.
What's Stanard's doing?
This takes us back to our running days at school athletics.
Athletics, yeah. That must have been, what, 10, 15 years ago.
And when you ran a 37-minute 10K?
Yeah, 20 kilograms ago. Sorry, work in kilograms, not age.
Five lots of 800 metres, one-to-one rest.
Time 2:52.
Horrible.
2:21. Jazz.
7:20.
Four down, one to go. This heat, 30 degrees today, really hurting. That fourth one really hurt. First two fine, third one was like, ooh, that one was like, ah. This one's gonna be like,
You didn't stop on the last one.
Nope.
What was it like being back at the track after too long?
Oh, mate, not long enough. I hate this track, especially anything over one lap.
These were my splits. Started off well, hurt a little bit, hurt a lot. Final one, pushed as hard as I could.
Do it all again next week.
Yep.
Which one did you get?
Watermelon and coconut.
Hashtag basic. Wristbands arrived for the CrossFit Games.
Oh my god, like literally just, can you imagine if these arrived after we left?
So yesterday was actually the hottest day of the year, and it's probably one of the hottest days ever recorded in the UK. My dad has made a makeshift out of a shower curtain, sun defence.
What do you mean? Just the job, isn't it? It's watching my head getting burnt, isn't it,
mate? That's all we need. Yes, but dad, it's our shower curtain.
It's utilising what you got, isn't it? It's a cheap way of doing it.
Jazz makes the best fajitas. Mixed peppers, sweet peppers and normal peppers, along with onion.
Then you get chicken and some garlic out the cupboard. Put it with this seasoning mix by Old El Paso for fajitas. Put it in a Latin America kitchen wrap. Tabasco.
How to make fajitas properly, Jazz. We did the track session. What the hell, I look like a pineapple. So Monday pull, Wednesday core, Friday push. Squat Monday, deadlift Wednesday, Friday's more endurance based.
8 minute EMOM, minute one, 15 strict handstand push-ups, minute two, 15 bent over rows with dumbbells, 2 minutes rest into 8 minute EMOM, 15 ring dips strict into 15 heavy dumbbell deadlifts on a plate.
As I said in the commentary earlier, posterior chain activation is probably my weakness, so just chucking it in as much as we can.
EMOM eight, 20 to 25 pistols, minute one, 30 press-ups.
Minute two, strength endurance. Yeah.
Super sweaty way to finish Friday. But the handstand push-ups got really freaking hard. And then made the ring dips hard for the next one, and then made the push-ups hard for the last one. The worst part though, there's deadlifts. Dumbbell on the block.
Ha. I went, Craig looked over at me at one point and I went down to do a pistol and then just sat on the floor.
I love Bieber just drops bangers. It's just a fact.
First got together and you were like, I'm gonna go like short on the sides and longer on the top like Bieber. That's what you said. That's why your hair like is like it is now.
9:15, Zed.
Nearly as old as you.
I think you're in the wrong class,
Jack.
I got my toe-to-toe on today.
Yeah, boxing.
How old is the dog, eh?
Which
one? Wow, yeah,
What's going on, team? I'm now back again with the commentary. Basically, Saturdays for me are either an open style workout with Olympic lifting, if we're sticking to the program, if we're traveling around, or as you saw today, I just jump in on the class. Saturdays are always partner workouts, so it's really nice sometimes just to jump in, keep that kind of partner intensity, because this year I've got a lot of partner competitions coming up and it's a different kind of feel to working out by yourself or even with intervals on EMOMs. It's usually super intense. You go, I go, and a lot of fun. You know, I want to stay in the community as much as I possibly can at Faber. I love the box. I love the people. After the workout, did a little bit of extra gymnastics. So I did a 12-minute EMOM of 5 ring muscle-ups every minute on the minute. 60 ring muscle-ups in total. Really happy with how it felt. And then went on to do just 5 minutes max distance handstand walk. And I don't know how far I went. I just went back up and down the gym. But just fun on the hand stuff. Didn't actually do any weightlifting. Didn't really feel like it, to be honest. And coming back after Kevin's in Germany, when I hit the 120 kilo snatch and the 140 clean and jerk, and they felt really good. You know, at the moment, I'm concentrating more on the strict strength with the squat program that we're currently on and the deadlift program that we're currently on, along with all the strict gymnastics. Weightlifting for me is a little bit on the back burner. We'll do it in Metcons at a lighter weight, but going heavy maybe once every 2 weeks. Just keep the movement there, ticking over and fresh. Anyway, this is the last training day of the week. So how it's usually structured is Thursday, as you saw, is an active recovery day, and Sunday is a complete rest day, completely off. And we're traveling across to America, which I'm super excited to film 14 days of epic content. So if you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button. If you're not part of the family, not part of the team, what the hell are you doing? And yeah, I'm gonna end the commentary here, but yeah, once again, smash that like button if you have enjoyed it, if you've got an insight into my training. I hope you've learned something.
The kids class doing bring Sally up, bring Sally down with the squats. Classic.